Hey everybody, this is Nick. I wanted to come to you with a really quick tip for embedding reference lines into your charts, like this quadrant chart here, a scatter plot, showing the execution and difficulty scores of all of the men in the all-around competition at the recent 2023 World Artistic Gymnastics Championships in Antwerp, Germany. So this is a chart that was really inspired by some other charts that I saw on Twitter from a journalist at the Washington Post, and I'll link to her profile below. Check her out. She's an awesome gymnastics journalist and sports journalist, and clearly a very adept data viz professional, much more adept than me. I'm gonna do this remake in Excel and PowerPoint just like we do here on this channel, but I think Emily at the Washington Post, she might have been using some other software, maybe Data Wrapper or maybe Tableau or Power BI, something that had tooltips, because she was able to embed them interactively into those sites, which is pretty cool. You could hover over all the dots and you could see the names of people and the scores and things like that. I'm not going to do that today. We're just going to do this in PowerPoint, and I'm not going to make this entire chart. I want you to comment below if you want me to make this entire chart from scratch, and I'll make another tutorial on that, but I just wanted to show you this really cool tip for embedding reference lines, these average lines here in the quadrant chart. So right here, these are just brute force lines that I estimated the value of, and I just drew them across the screen, made sure they were horizontal, made sure they were vertical, and then called it a day. I exported this as an image. But what if you really want those lines to be embedded in the chart, to be part of the chart, and you want them to be exact? This is how you can do it. Now, I've seen some people, they will create an entire line of dots and then connect them, but you can actually just create one series of dots for each of your X and Y value, and then just use an error bar to do it, and use a custom length. And we've done this in other videos before with our connected dot plots, our dumbbell dot plots, things like that. But here's how we do it. So all of my scatter plot data is in the chart right here, and you can see this little, these two little orange dots. This is a dot that I already added to the chart, and this is a dot that I already added to the chart, added the exact value of the average execution and the average difficulty. Let's go ahead, let's click on the average difficulty dot right here. All you need to do is add error bars. So let's go ahead up to the chart design tab, click on add chart element, and go to the error bar drop-down menu. Let's click on more error bar options. And what this does is it gives you a default X and Y error bar. Now I don't need the vertical error bar here. That's the Y error bar. So I'm gonna go ahead and delete that. Now the X error bar, the horizontal one, is what I want. So over here in the format error bar menu, I'm gonna click on plus because we just want the side that goes above to the right of that dot. I'm gonna say no cap, and then under fixed value, you see it's only going a length of one, and that's why it stops right here. But this is actually going to be, what was this? 12, a length of 12, I think. So let's go ahead and just type in 12. Oh, maybe it is 13. So type in that length, type in any length, and you can see how that error bar adjusts. It goes all the way to the end of the chart. And now it's an exact line, it's embedded in your chart, and if you wanted to ever move this line, you could do that on the source data. So what I'm gonna do then is use the paint bucket. I'm going to make this a very light color gray. I'm gonna make it 2-point width, and then we're gonna make it a dashed line here for that average. Now that's super, super cool. Now, I don't need that fake orange marker anymore, so I'm just gonna click on that orange dot marker, go over here to that paint bucket under the format data series, under marker options, click on that little marker options dropdown, and I'm just gonna select none, and that just removes the marker from the screen. Now let's just do this one more time for the execution right here. I'm gonna click on that, we're gonna add error bars. Another way you can add error bars is by clicking on the little plus sign up here, that's called a skittle. And we're gonna go ahead and click on this error bar menu and say more options so that we open up that format error bar menu. Now we don't need the horizontal error bar, so I'm just gonna click on those, see if I can isolate that. Oh, it looks like it's kind of difficult. It's making me select the axis, but now it looks good. So I can go ahead and delete that. And then click on that vertical error bar. Again, we're gonna say plus. We just want the plus part, the part above the dot. And then I'm gonna say no cap. And this is going to be 7, was that calculation right there. And then we're going to just make that gray, update it to 2 points, you would just update it to taste however you want it. But that is one way then that you can go ahead and you can embed. Now I can click on those error bars and they're not gonna move. They're not a separate line shape. They're embedded directly in the chart. So when you want to have things like reference lines in a scatter plot or a line chart, you may just put in one single dot and then try and work with the error bars to see if they would provide you with a helpful solution to those reference line problems. So if you want to see me make this chart from scratch, comment below and I'll make a tutorial at a later date. It's a pretty cool chart type, but this was a really cool way to embed those reference lines. And I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. I had a great time making this for you. I hope you had a great time watching, and I can't wait to see you all next time.